Yeah. Lord, we will sing of your goodness. In fact, we will testify to the whole world. Look what the Lord has done. I was blind, now I see. I was lame, now I walk. I was dumb, now I speak. Look what the Lord has done. Grateful. Lord, I'm grateful for your grace.
Sing your song, yeah. utukufu wako watenda mema. Nani kama wewe?
Utukufu wako watenda.
Si nani kama wewe? Utukufu wako watenda mema.
Nani kama wewe? Utukufu wako watenda mema.
With every hand lifted up, let's sing it together.
Amen. Amen. Yahweh, Yahweh. Oh, Kaka. Oh, yeah, Kerua.
Amen.
Jehovah. Amen.
Sema asante, twasema asante, twasema asante. Thank you to Jesus right now. Open your mouth, open your heart. Tell Jehovah, thank you. Abba, thank you. Father, thank you. Thank you for 2022. Thank you for getting us here. Thank you for your grace, for your mercies, for your power, for the things that you have done in our lives. Lord, we have come back to say thank you. Come on, lift your voice. Open your heart, open your mouth with your own words. Say thank you to your Father. Only you know how far He has brought you. Only you understand what 2022 has been like. This moment right here is for our Father and our God. This moment right here is to say thank you. Oh, we say thank you, Lord. If you don't hear anything else from our hearts today, if you don't get to say anything else, may you hear that we are grateful. We're grateful for your love upon our lives. You know, the service is a testimony service, and I'm standing here looking back at 2022 and the things that God has done in my life. I could stand here the whole day and tell you stories. 2022 will be a year I will remember for the rest of my life. Let me give you three testimonies, just three, and then we'll move on. In February of 2022, I got married. A little late after that, our family, my dad's side of the family, has been one of the most broken families I've ever heard of. I don't know about your families, but my family, where? My younger cousin, who we've been raised together with, is getting married next week on Friday. Here, that's not the testimony yet. Through his wedding, he managed to invite all his uncles and aunties, and we were there. I got to see uncles and aunties that I haven't seen in 7 years, 10 years plus. Because of family wrangles, even us, even siblings, uncles and aunties decided, we don't want to meet your families. But the miracle for me was that even despite the wrangles, we still could sit and feed from the same plate. That was a prayer that I had made for decades. My dad got so sick. He was admitted in hospital for weeks. Truth is, one day he woke up and said, "Today is the day I'm going home." But people of God prayed right here in this church. Hey, if you see my dad, he looks like a bouncing baby boy, and he's my dad. God healed him completely and restored him completely. Then Pastor Sam told us about the future, and I remember we sat and thought, "Ay, tupeane yote." But I'll tell you for a fact, in 2022 I got out of debt. I am a testimony of being free from debt. In fact, I got out of debt and then I started saving. Like I'm on the ladder going upwards. Today we're going to hear a lot of testimonies. My prayer is that you shall be yielded to hear what God is saying. In fact, my prayer is that through this service shall set the pace for you in 2023. Tell your neighbor, this is the least you will ever be. Tell them, this is the smallest we shall ever be. Our God is faithful. Our God is good. Amen. Is anybody excited to bring testimonies, to bring words of gratitude to our Father and our God? Come on, if you know God has been faithful for you and to you, to your family and children. Some of you are here and you passed your exams. Some of you are here and you are promoted at work. Lift up your hands, lift up your voice. Give the Lord a mighty shout of praise. What a joy it is to be in the house of the Lord on this first day of the year. Hey, I am so excited. We have people who are joining us live on YouTube right now. In fact, today is a special day. We are on the main Mavuno page. Today we are not in our Hillcity page. So we have more people watching all across the world. Welcome to Hillcity. Come on, let's tell them. Welcome to Hillcity. We are so glad that we can host you this morning. I pray that God will minister to you just as he's ministering to us. In fact, go on your comment section right now and post your testimony. We're going to read it out to the rest of the people right here. Okay, please turn to your neighbor. Give them a high five. Tell them Happy New Year. It's good to see you. Oh, I can tell them I can see the glory of God all over your life. And please proceed to have your seats even as you're turning your attention to the screens. We have some video messages for you. God bless you, Mavuno.
Happy New Year, Mavuno Church. My name is Moreidi Wanjao, Senior Pastor of the Mavuno Movement of Churches, and I am so excited to usher us into 2023. God has been so faithful. We're here. We have testimonies today. We're going to be sharing some of those testimonies in our service about what God has done. What an amazing thing. As we look back, it may not have been an easy year for you, but I know the fact that we're here already testifies of God's goodness, and I can't wait to see what God does for all of us and in all of us in the year to come. Now, as we're looking forward into this year, there are some exciting things we're launching the year with. In exactly a week's time, we're starting off with our 21-day fast, and it's going to be a liquid fast. We're encouraging us this year. We've done that before as a church, 21 days of just liquids. You can go on our website and read about how to do a liquid fast. But one other thing we're asking you to do this year is actually we want to take a 21-day, as we do our liquid fast, I'm going to be encouraging every single one of us to also do a social media fast. That's right. I want to encourage you to just go delete those apps, your Instagram, your WhatsApp, your Snapchat, whatever it is. Just take it off your phone for now. You don't have to deactivate the account. You can go back on it afterwards. But let's take that time. that we're normally on social media and be able to instead spend time with God. And you know, I want to encourage every single one of you to, if you have questions, go on the website. You'll be able to see some frequently asked questions and you can ask about that. What about our Bible reading? That's the second thing we're doing this year. We're going through the New Testament together and I'm looking forward to it. We're going to start in the book of Matthew. We're actually starting today. And so go on the YouVersion app if you already haven't. Download that. And again, the instructions are on our website. There's some on the page right now, on the screen right now. And you can actually be able to download. It's a great app. You can invite your friends or your discipleship group into it. And let's read the New Testament together this year. Let's walk together through this New Testament journey. And then finally, we're also going to be giving our first fruits. I'm encouraging every single one of us who considers this, their Mavuno family, this family, their home, that we're giving our January income. If you go on the website, you'll be able to find out how to do this, but also on the Mavuno app. If you're on the Android, if you have an Android phone, you can download the Mavuno app and it'll give you some ways. You'll be able to see how to even pledge. You can do it within 1 month, which is what we encourage people to do, take a step of faith. But if you find that that's a bit difficult for you because of your circumstances, you can actually break that monthly income into several months and be able to fulfill your pledge. And again, with every single one of these, I know they're going to be specific, incredible testimonies of faith building as we just trust God to glorify Himself as we do this. Why are we giving our fast food offering? This year, we want to dedicate our fast food offering not only to helping pay off our mortgage at the Hillcity campus, but we also want to buy land for one of our campuses. We're still figuring out which one. Let's give generously because we're trusting God that as we do this, it's going to actually free up our resources for us to be able to buy land for every single Mavuno campus in the few years that are coming. So, hey, I'm looking forward to seeing what this year is going to be about. Remember, go onto the App Store, download the Mavuno app. It's got all this information, and I can't wait to see what 2023 has for every single one of us. The verse for this year, Daniel 11:32, the second part, it says, the people who know their God will be strong and do exploits. I really believe that this will be an incredible year of exploits. And next week, we start a new series. We're going to be talking about a Champions League, how to prepare for your overnight success. I believe that every one of us, God is calling us to a successful year this year. And I can't wait to see every one of you next week as we jump into God's word and begin to prepare for the year that God has ahead for us. Happy New Year and God bless you.
Happy New Year to you too, Pastor.
Come on, guys. Thank you very much. You can do better than that.
Good morning. Hey. Okay, so I understand that all of us were at crossover, but at least we have energy. Good morning, Elaine.
Good morning to you too.
And he's not slept in 3 days. Okay.
Do not worry about that. Good morning, Mavuno.
Good morning, church. So we're going to do something interesting. You know, Maluki has been saying, say hi to your neighbor. Mm. And then you assume your neighbor is the person seated next to you.
Mm.
Sindio?
Yes.
Now let's say good morning and happy new year to the person seated behind you.
Indeed. Let's take a moment.
So
just get up.
Tell the person behind you, happy new year.
Get to find out their name. Get to find out how they spent their New Year's Eve.
Network.
Whether they were at crossover or whether they were watching the Arsenal game, like some people I know.
Yeah, we know. Those who didn't come to crossover yesterday.
Those who didn't come to crossover.
We can see the jerseys.
Yeah, indeed. But
all right.
Brenda, There's something interesting if you've noticed.
Okay.
Our amazing pastors are putting on kitenge, right?
Cindy-o.
We have other pastors putting on kitenge. We have people in the audience putting on kitenge. Did we get the memo?
No, the question is you're a pastor.
Uh-uh.
You are the one who didn't get. At least for me, I've been like, you know what? Maybe it's Kokoyo WhatsApp group.
Pastor Jemo.
But you. They did. Everyone can view butts. But it's okay.
Seems like as if spending the whole night here did not allow me to spend time on my WhatsApp. I'm a kwangaleo Arsenal game.
No, but
it's okay.
You know the good thing is what?
What?
Mrs. Ishimwe has represented you. She's in Akitenge.
Ah, my beautiful, amazing wife who is over there. Thank you. You are amazing. Maluki, please move. I can't see my wife. Amazing. Good morning, each and every one of you. It's such an honor to be here on the first Sunday of the year 2023.
Hey.
Today is such an amazing Sunday. My name is Ishimwe Alain. I'll be your host today. I am one of the pastors here at Mavuno Church and a certified leadership coach. Thank you guys very much. Brenda, it is your turn.
Certified. Wow, okay, sour. Good morning, church. My name is Brenda Mutio. I'm an associate at Mavuno Hillcity, a proud associate.
Come on now.
I love what I do here.
I think they're not hearing you well. To me,
okay, sour. Good morning, church. Happy New Year. I can see faces from last Sunday, guys, who promised the woman of God they'll be here. Mbarikiwe sana, y'all didn't lie to me. So I'm a proud associate at Mavuno Hillcity. I serve under Mavuno Kids. I can see all the amazing kids in the house.
Come on, come on now, come on. Let's give it up for all the kids in the house.
And it's such an honor to be in the house of the Lord on the first day of the year.
Indeed.
On a Sunday.
Indeed.
As in, if my ear is starting off on such a high note like this with all this excitement, I cannot wait. You know, guys are actually asking if there's a crossover 2.0, but that's a story for another day.
Brenda, here's an interesting fact. Do you know that today we're all visitors?
Eh.
Today, indeed, we're all visitors.
How? Please explain.
Look at your neighbor and actually tell them, welcome, visitor. Do you know the reason why we're all visitors?
Welcome, visitor.
Right?
Yeah.
Because the Lord has ushered in into the year of 2023.
Oh, okay.
On the first Sunday of the year. And so today we're all visitors. But allow me to take this time, please, if you're a first-time visitor here, raise your hand. We want to celebrate
first
you and appreciate
visitors.
You for coming. Yes, we have a brother over there. Hey, please, Mavuno, we can do better than that. We have someone else over
welcome
there.
Welcome to Mavuno Hill.
Amazing, we have many more. Wow, today we have a lot of visitors.
Hey, okay.
Isn't it?
Should every day be New Year's?
Every day is a New Year.
Oh.
If you heard Pastor Milton say it, every day is a New Year.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay. Welcome so very much. I can assure you from a personal point of view, this place is an amazing place to grow spiritually, and not just spiritually, even emotionally, mentally, even monetary. If you have the right connections, you know, all these poor connections, network, okay. But welcome to church. We love visitors, by the way. They do love visitors. They actually do. Mbona mnapenda visitors hivyo, by the way.
Just a second. Please, if you are a visitor for our usher, so that they can recognize you, please keep
your hand
up. They are giving you something amazing. That's a Mavuno gift from us, which is going to give you access to our VIP lounge. Understand this, the VIP lounge where you get 7 minutes of your time to have a great and amazing, Pastor Jemo says it's called a TED Talk.
TED Talk.
TED Talk.
He calls it a TED Talk.
It's a TED Talk because he gets to know you and you get to know us. Amazing, amazing.
We shall discuss further.
You are still asleep. All right.
Okay.
So, Brenda, tell us.
I can tell you a lot of things, but
Brenda,
break it down.
The script.
Oh, apako script.
Don't take us.
Okay, sawa. So, poleni, I'm a storyteller. So, it's a new year. We are entirely grateful for that. Sindio?
Yes, yes, indeed.
Can you remember actually last year's word from Pastor M?
Last year's word. Come on, let's say it together. No eye has, no ear has, no mind can. What? Okay, let's do it again. No eye
has seen,
no ear has, no mind can.
Comprehend. Oh, okay,
hey. Kuna watu walienda English group of schools. I'm hearing comprehend.
Fathom.
I'm hearing fathom. Hey, sawa. Let us use the word that I know it was. No mind
has conceived.
Yes. Sawa.
Yes.
All right. No mind has conceived the things God has in store for us. Hasn't that been an amazing year?
It really has.
Didn't we get to see the things God has in store for us?
Yes.
Are we still in anticipation for those things that are happening?
Yes.
Indeed, indeed. Brenda, please tell us, why do we think that we anticipated this moment?
Wow, okay. Well, that's a very good question. Well, that's a very good question. Could you say it again?
Brenda. Brenda is asleep, guys. Let's allow her. Why did we perceive that these things were going to happen? But aside from that, watch ni kuacha hapa, ni kuacha kwa matasi, ndio?
Please, tafadhali, make me look good.
So tell us, what do you think this year looks like?
This year is going to be about acceleration and ease.
Eish.
And it's not just acceleration. See, we are accelerating and we are moving fast like fireworks. It's with ease. You know, as in, are you guys getting what I'm saying? It's fireworks acceleration with ease. Like, you'll accelerate. God will move you from point A to point Z, but with so much ease, you won't even believe it.
Oh my God, isn't it? Come on, like with the Arsenal fans, let us celebrate, because this month we are going to be having an amazing series titled Champions League.
Umesema Champions League ama Premier League?
Guys, it's not the soccer that we're talking about, the Arsenal, the Arsivo. It's Champions League. What's the slogan for this sound series?
Champions League, how to prepare for your overnight success.
Guys, not microwave solutions. Sawa.
Not fraud. Or wash.
It is a moment for us to be able to go into that sound series where we actually become champions. But it takes us to pray, to seek Him, and also to dedicate our time towards loving and enjoying, to read God's word. So guys,
if I say obedience, will I be off track?
There is obedience, but it's okay.
No, you know, I hear Pastor James saying obedience, discipleship. So does that have anything to do with it?
Tell us. Obedience is God's love language. Pastor James always emphasizes that. So if you're not obedient, then I don't know what love language you're actually showing
us. I will not accelerate with ease.
Yes.
Okay, so.
All right. Tell us, what else do we have?
We are actually doing a New Testament read through.
Whole year. Indeed. We shall have the New Testament challenge that we shall be reading through.
Yes.
And guys, please do not be like Brenda. While we were practicing, she said something that I am standing away.
No.
I was asking her give me some of the books, the major prophets.
No.
And she says Ezekiel. Guys, I don't know, Pastor James, I don't know which book Ezekiel is in the Old Testament.
I said.
It's a major prophet, but I asked her the
books. He's a major prophet.
Right? And she said one of the books is called Ezekiel.
Please. I answered the question the way I understood it. Not the way you wanted it to be answered. But I gave you an answer at the end of the day.
Okay.
You're burning. you're very much burning.
It's okay. But in the spirit of that, guys, this says that we should actually get to join this challenge. It's going to be amazing. It's done within our discipleship groups. Yeah. But as well, this will allow us to read the Bible for ourselves and not wait for Pastor Jemo to come and read it for us on Sunday.
Yeah, and be Cindy, like me, who says Elijah is a book of the Old Testament. What? Okay.
I should consult your discipleship group leader.
I am the discipleship group leader.
Oh my God.
Whose
group?
I promise. It was an honest mistake. However, it would be so nice to read through the New Testament with guys, you know, listening to different points of views.
Indeed.
Yeah, like that Jesus turning water into wine. Mm-hmm. Did he actually drink the wine?
I don't know.
No such questions.
These are speculations.
Yeah. Anyway, it's fine. So we are going to have the New Testament in 1 year challenge. It's going to be on the U Version Bible app, so
indeed,
you can
indeed
download it. What to Apple, we can download it. We are sorted.
Indeed.
We can.
And that you can actually be able to see is going to be actually on the U Version app. You'll have easy guided steps, but as well, your discipleship leaders will make it easier for you by sending you a link which will actually give you access to go directly to that. Sawa?
Yes.
That'll be a much easier way that will be done.
Now let's get to the part that they are really waiting for.
The part that I'm really waiting for, Brenda, is that I will be spending the next 21 days fasting for you to know the books of the Bible.
Where? That is a low blow. But thank you.
So all right.
In the process of you fasting and praying for me to know the Bibles, can I send you a list of other things you need to pray for?
No problem.
Siombe tu moja, like I'll give you a whole spreadsheet. Good.
That's
so
fine.
Guys, we are getting into our 21 days of fasting.
Yes.
We didn't move it, by the way. I know you guys, some people were hoping that maybe first January, they'll go, you know, they'll be like, you know, we're still doing a 21 day of fasting and it's going to start on the 9th. That is next week on Monday.
Next week on Monday. That's
yes?
very correct.
Yes, it's going to be next week on Monday.
Are we ready? The only people who are saying yes are only the front row people. Well, maybe let me try to do like my look and move closer at the back. Are we ready? Eish, even
are we
kids.
Ready for the 21-day?
Oh my fast. God. Awesome, awesome, awesome.
Fasting and praying. You're not just going to ati not eat, but you're also praying. Cindy, oh.
See weight loss program.
See weight loss program.
Sawa. Najua Christmas tumekula. Na tumeshiba. It's not a weight loss program. All right.
We have not been told well, by the way. But
it's not a fast track for us to be able to get fit.
It's not a box that we need to check off as well.
That's very true.
Yeah, it's not because your pastor said fast. Fast because you know the real meaning of fasting and you know what happens when you're fasting and you're praying. Prayers are answered.
Indeed, indeed.
Yes,
indeed.
Yes, yes.
And for me, the lessons that I get to remember, I keep looking at Geneva and the things that I remember. She talked about having an appointment with the Holy Spirit.
Hey, Nikona appointment.
Hey. Having an appointment with the Holy Spirit.
Asante Baba. Hi, I have your office. Eh, apana, maluki atakuja kwa stage.
Tuache maluki tafadhali.
So guys, 21 days of fasting is going to start next week on Monday. We are welcoming each and every one of you to join in the dry fast. Liquid fast.
Yeah.
Liquid, sorry.
It's liquid.
Did you talk about dry? But liquid fast.
All right.
So anyway.
Indeed, indeed. Even as we get to fast, as we get to get have a moment where we get to worship God, praise Him. But hey, Mavuno, we have so many ways that we get to adore Him. We get to worship God. That's already in our word, in our worship, and in
our giving.
Indeed, indeed. And now it's time for giving. Guys, if you want to be able to give, our ushers are going to come around you and you'll be able to have the opportunity to give if you want to give in cash. But as well, if you want to be able to give through our M-Pesa details, they will be on the screen.
On the screen, yes.
Even our bank accounts are on the screen. But if you'd love to swipe, hapa ndo napata bonga points tena. Please go to my wife at the back who will be able to help you. And she is going to be helped as well by Pastor Zilani. I hope I'm seeing the right people at the back.
You're
all right. Yes, yes, yes. Amazing, amazing. That will. And now, it is that moment, Brenda.
Yes.
That we can see they're already standing here because they want us to leave.
I think we've overdone it.
We've overdone it.
But see, you guys have understood everything we've said.
Have we been amazing hosts?
Cindy, I mean,
can you appreciate us by
Cindy
at least giving us a very round,
a very nice
big applause of our club? That's
thanks,
it.
Thanks, thanks.
And as we do that, allow me to welcome an amazing man, an amazing gentleman, someone who does things that I cannot do.
Neither
put
can
words
I.
together and so that they can rhyme and give you an amazing, amazing speech. Please welcome Evangelical Poet on stage.
Welcome very much.
Good morning, wonderful people. Yeah, so what are you grateful for? What are you grateful for? So, for me, as last year approached its demise, I was lowly and wounded. Quitting kept topping the list of my endless thoughts. What good would come from a story like me, I wondered. Discovery, huh? The discovery program. Is God even serious? I thought, low key. Why would he expose my weaknesses in a place where I needed to look good? Where I needed to build a CV that will set me up for my next big win? Doesn't God relate to how badly I want to be employed next year? Or, sorry, this year? My photography has started paying and all, but the inconsistencies, my word can't pay the rent. I want to be independent from my parents, I thought. I had every reason to see how things were working against me. My poetry was blooming slowly in the background. I couldn't even hear it. For me to see that God's plans were still working out. Because you see, God loves to play the background. I had every reason to doubt in God's formidable plans. I, like every one of you, had nothing except God's word. So I asked Pastor James, "Yo, what you grateful for in regard to last year?" And then he was like, "I'm grateful for God's word." And for me, it sounded quite absurd because I would be grateful for money, a job, a house, or something like that. Funny how God's word is all we have, the currency for the present and the future. So I guess I'm thankful too, not for all the wealth in the world, but for God's provision of the word. Like how he told Abraham, "Into the land I send you, go." I'm grateful, thankful for the word, for what's yet to come, thankful for God's love, for just like you, I'm entering 2023 with the assurance that God's not through with me yet. Just like the Shunammite woman, uncertain that there is anything to go back to after a war. Yet his word still stands to me and you, that no eye has seen, no ear has heard, and no mind has conceived the things that God has prepared for us who love him. Evangelical poet.
The internet is full of stories of men and women who seemingly came out of nowhere to become champions, entrepreneurs who made millions, and known artists who become household names, and gifted athletes who achieved GOAT status. But is there such a thing as an overnight success? What does it take to become an immediate sensation? And is there a recipe or a formula that can move us into a different league from where we're playing at right now? This January at Mavuno Church, come and discover what you need to do to prepare for your overnight success. Join us in our first series of the year 2023 and learn how to join the Real Champions League.
Wow, good morning Mavuno. Happy New Year. Oh, come on, turn to someone close to you and tell them Happy New Year. Tell them it's great to see you at church this morning. Wow. Look, every now and then I find myself in a moment where I'm tempted to sing. And in a moment like this, the song, there's that song that says, "Looks like we made it." Ni nani najua kuimba? Anyway, we made it. 2023 is here. Look what the Lord has done. Anybody have some things that they are grateful for? Oh, I'm so grateful, I'm so thankful. I recognize that it has taken God's hand, God's goodness, God's kindness to me, for me to make it this year, to make it here to this new year. For our first time visitors, I'm Pastor James Mushai. I'm the lead pastor here at Mavuno Hillcity. Can we just celebrate our visitors one more time? We are so glad that you're worshiping with us. We are so glad to be starting off the new year together with you. And like we said, we want to connect with you a little bit at the end of the service. If this is your very first time at Mavuno Hillcity, we want to ask that you meet with us when you exit this dome. To your left, there's a tent. You'll see it. It has some setup for the event we had last night, and our guest experience team will be ready to receive you, just to connect with you a little bit. But we are so glad that you're able to join us. I also want to celebrate our online audience. Come on, Mavuno Hill City, let's celebrate everybody joining us online. Karibu sana to Mavuno Church Hill City Campus. We are so glad to be connecting with you this morning. We'll be spending a significant amount of time just giving thanks to God for his goodness. But I want to just take a moment to give thanks to some incredibly special people. And these are the people who serve here at Mavuno Hill City. For some of you, you were here last night. We had an incredible time just crossing over into the new year. We had lots of music, performances, prayer, worship, and many other activities. And the thing you might not know is that for this service to happen this morning, literally, there are people who spent the night here. And they were worth our celebration. And I just want to say I'm so thankful for our services team, our tech guys, everybody involved in setup, guys who came in early yesterday morning and pulled off the event, guys who worked late into the night, guys who looked for a couch somewhere here in the premises and slept for a few hours to be able to serve today. And I want to invite you, Mavuno Hillcity, just join me in celebrating the incredible men and women who make this possible. We celebrate you. You're our heroes in 2023. And I want to start by making this declaration. Your labor in the Lord is never in vain. That the Lord sees every sacrifice you make, every hour of sleep you have lost, every ache and every pain. Where is Pastor Alain? Pastor Alain was on his feet for close to 24 hours yesterday. And I know even his feet are in pain, even as he's hosting us today. And I just thank you. I'm proud to be serving in this church, in this place where I see you, Pastor Alain. You can sit now, finally. Pastor Maluki was on stage. I'm so proud to be a part of this community. I love my church. Mavuno Hillcity, and I thank God for everyone who serves here with us. Amen. I want us to welcome also a special group of people here into this hall. For some of you who worship here every Sunday, you might not know this, but this facility actually hosts two churches. It hosts Mavuno Church Hillcity, and we gather here for our adults gathering and young adults. And we have a second campus that meets right on this property, a second church, and that's our Mavuno Swahili campus. And they are here with us this morning. We are worshiping together. What's your Swahili campus? If you could raise your hand. Pastor Jacob, let me just ask you and your wife to stand up. Let's celebrate this amazing couple. So right on these premises, not outside, we have a Swahili church, and today they're here worshiping with us. We celebrate you, and we thank you for joining us today. Karibuni sana. Thank you so much. Let's celebrate them one more time. I have an invitation for every single one of you. We'll be reading through the New Testament this year. If you're not in a discipleship group, I'm going to ask that you sign up right at the end of the service. It's critical that we plug you into a discipleship group. If you have never been a part of one, if your group stops meeting or you've been struggling to meet regularly, we want to place you in a new group because we're going to be reading through the New Testament in groups so that we are learning and we're growing together. So if you're not already in a group, I'm going to ask that you sign up at the back and we will plug you in immediately and you'll get a link so that you can be reading. Even as as your new group starts to form, and we want to read through the scriptures together. As I thought about it, I actually realized, like for real, the thing I'm most grateful for in 2022 is God's word. Just the capacity to hear him and to learn from him and to find instruction step by step in different seasons of that year. So if you're not in a discipleship group, you can sign up at the back. We'll plug you into one and we can read through the Bible together. If you don't have the YouVersion app on your phone, you'll need to download it because it's what makes it possible for us to lead. Hallelujah. For us to read. Are you guys also asleep? Nobody even noticed that I said to lead the Bible together. Hallelujah. That is the error factor. You know where I'm from. So please sign up for a discipleship group if you're not in one. The new year is always an exciting time. The new year always excites hope. Anything is possible in a new year. It's possible to dream, finally. Especially if, the previous year was a little bit difficult. You know, you find yourself being able to hope for better and to trust that something good can come out of the new year. And, you know, all the Arsenal fans have hope that finally they will win the Premier League after a long time. And all the Man City fans, like my son here, have hope in the new year that they will catch up with Arsenal. I don't see it happening. But the new year excites hope in every situation. You know, all the France fans can hope that Mbappe will lift the World Cup again in 2020. Uh-huh. The new year excites hope in different areas, in different parts of our lives. And that's an exciting thing to see. And today we're going to be having some time of thanksgiving. And I want to share with us briefly from God's word. We're going to read from the book of Exodus, chapter 15. For Brenda, Exodus is the second book in the Bible. I'm just being helpful. We're going to read from Exodus chapter 15. We're going to read verse 1, and then we're going to read from verse 21, I believe it is, to the end of the chapter. Exodus chapter 15, verse 1. I'm going to ask that we read together, those of you who are here for the overnight. I know you might be struggling to stay up, so I'm going to do this together with you. Let's read together. Then Moses, one, two, go. Then Moses and the people of Israel sang this song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. He has hurled both horse and rider into the sea. We're going to skip to verse 21. And Miriam sang this song. Sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. He has hurled both into the sea. I seem to be having some trouble with my mic. We can continue. Verse 22. Then Moses led the people of Israel away from the Red Sea, and they moved out into the desert of Shur. They traveled in this desert for 3 days without finding any water. When they came to the oasis of Marah, the water was too bitter to drink. So they called that place Marah, which means bitter. Verse 24, then the people complained and turned against Moses. What are we going to drink? They demanded. So Moses cried out to the Lord for help, and the Lord showed him a piece of wood. Moses threw it into the water, and this made the water good to drink. Are we still together? It was there at Marah that the Lord set before them the following decree as a standard to test their faithfulness to him. He said, if you will listen carefully to the voice of the Lord, your God, and do what is right in his sight, obeying his commands and keeping all his decrees, then I will not make you suffer any of the diseases I sent on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who heals you. Come on, somebody. Verse 27, after leaving Marah, the Israelites traveled on to the oasis of Elim, where they found 12 springs and 70 palm trees. They camped there beside the water. Our Lord and our King, we thank you for your word, and we thank you because you have something in store for us today. We thank you that you're already moving in our midst, and we just present ourselves to you. Would you come? Would you have your way? Would you minister? Would you do everything that you desire to do as we enter into this year 2023? Would you take over and just be in charge? In Jesus' name we pray. And all God's people said, amen. This is an interesting story, and I'm gonna highlight several things that I see, and I want to draw for us a lesson that I think is a good lesson for us to enter 2023 with. The context of this story is the first thing I want to share with you. This is how that chapter started. Then Moses and the children and the people of Israel sang this song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. He has hurled both horse and rider into the sea. It starts with the entire nation of Israel singing this praise song. It ends with Miriam singing another song that seems to have the same chorus where it says, and Miriam sang this song, sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. He has hurled both horse and rider into the sea. The context of this story is that the children of Israel, being led by Moses, had just left Egypt, and they had found themselves trapped because the Egyptian army was behind them and the Red Sea was ahead of them, and they were stuck. And God had parted the Red Sea. Many of you will know that story. And they had walked across the sea on dry ground, and then the Egyptian army had come in after them, and God had drowned them all. That's the thing that they were celebrating. That's the context for this story. That at the beginning of this conversation, at the beginning of this chapter, they are celebrating one of the most dramatic miracles recorded in the scriptures. The parting of the Red Sea so that millions of people could get across it on dry land. That's the first thing that I see, that there was an amazing victory. But then secondly, I see that there came very quickly a legitimate crisis. And the crisis was that now they are walking in the desert and they couldn't find any water. The second thing I see is that the reality was that they had a significant challenge, and it was a legitimate one. But the third thing I want to draw your attention is their response. I don't know if you caught their response. How did they respond? It says they complained against Moses, because every problem we encounter is the fault of our leader, isn't it? Yeah, we know a little bit about that as Kenyans. Yeah, I've been seeing lots of complaints about, anyway, let me not get into that. So it's the leader's fault. Everything rises and falls on leadership. That's what they say. And so they complained against Moses. They complained against Moses because now you've brought us into the wilderness and now we don't have water and we are thirsty. That's the third thing that I see, that their response was to complain. But I also see that God performed a miracle because they were at this place that they named Marah because the water was bitter. And God showed Moses, you know, to cut a stick or pick a stick or whatever it was and to put it in the water, and the water became sweet. So I see that God intervened for them to receive exactly what they needed, which was water for them to drink. This could be a story about God providing miraculously. But I want to draw your attention to the ending of the story. Because the end of the story shows us that God had already made provision for the children of Israel. I'm going to ask that we put up verse 27 again. God had already made provision for the children of Israel because it says, after they drank the water and they proceeded on their journey, what did they find? They found an, after leaving Marah, the Israelites traveled on to the oasis of Elim, where they found what? 12 springs and 70 palm trees. They camped there beside the water. I feel like as we enter into the new year, there are probably three categories of people, whether you're here or you're watching online, that you could be in one of these three spaces. For some of us, you're neutral. You know, it's just a change in date that we have moved from the month of December 2022 into the month of January 2023. You're neutral. You're not, you know, excited or blown away one way or the other. You're okay, you're glad, but it doesn't mean too much to you. It could be that you're here and that's the place you're at. But I believe that God has a word for you, even if you've been here, feeling like, okay, I'm not enthusiastic, I'm not happy, I'm not sad, I'm just there. But I believe that if you're here, you need to be giving thanks. And I'm going to share with you why. Because it has taken the hand of God for you to get into January 1st, 2023. I have found that many times after God has performed a miracle, it's easy for me to be neutral and to forget it quickly. It's easy for me to recognize it in the moment and be excited and then go back into life and just operate as though God hasn't done something great and something profound for me. If you're here and that's the space you're in, then you must give thanks to God because it is through His power and through His goodness that you have made it this far. For some of us, we are here and we are over the moon. We are super excited at the things that God has done for us. We are here and we are like Moses and the children of Israel. We are like, what was her name? Miriam, Moses' elder sister, who are declaring the Lord has hurled both the horse and the rider into the sea. You have seen God give you victory. You have waited on Him in 2022 and He has answered your prayers. And here you are. And you must remember to give thanks to God and to come and say to Him, I recognize that I saw your provision. I recognize that you protected me. I recognize that you healed me. Those are the things that Pastor Maluki was doing. He's naming every victory that God has given him. We need to enter into a space of thanksgiving as we start this new year because of the victories we can see and that we are unaware of. Where we have been neutral, we need to be deliberate about spotting the things that God has done and saying, you have done this for me. I'm alive. I'm in church. I am here because it has taken your hand. But as I thought about today, I realized it's possible that there's a third category of people that you're here and you're in a very difficult space. It's possible that you're here and the word Marah defines what's going on with your life. It says that there was a stream and they couldn't drink the waters because they were bitter. And so they named that place Marah. It wasn't called that before. Marah means bitter. It's possible that for you, you're barely here. You had to drag yourself into church because you feel like life has been so hard and a change of date has not changed anything for you. And you've been in a difficult space. I believe that for you as well, you're in the right place in a Thanksgiving service and that you need to be here giving thanks to God. Because in this story, I see that God intervened in the situation that the children of Israel were facing, that He was able to enter into that space of no water and provide water. And as I have prayed for this service, as we've been preparing, my prayer has been that for every single person, the places where you need an intervention, that God will come through. So that then you won't be stuck in that place of Mara, that place of feeling like you're stuck in difficulty and in pain and complaining, but that you will recognize that God can intervene. But perhaps a more critical thing is that you will recognize that Mara is not your destination. It's just a stopover. The mistake that the children of Israel made is they thought this was the place that God had brought them to. They complained that there is no water and God performed a miracle, but the reason for the miracle is their complaining, because he already had in store for them 12 springs. How many tribes of Israel were rescued from Egypt? God had provided abundantly. He had catered for every tribe, for Judah and Issachar and the sons of Joseph, and every single tribe was already provided for, but all they could see is, oh my gosh, we are so thirsty right now. And so they complained against Moses. Why have you brought us into the wilderness? Do you know that we were living close to the river Nile? We always had all the water we needed. And so I see that even for those of us who might be in a difficult space right now, we can come and be thankful for some of the things that God has done, but we can also have an attitude that recognizes that he is still taking care of us. Tell your neighbor, Mara is not a destination. For the chosen people of God, for the children of God, for me, Mara is not my destination. David, the psalmist, puts it differently in Psalm 23. He says, yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, he recognizes that the shadow of death is not his destination. It's not where he will live and spend his life. I forgot to memorize the verse. It's a verse in Jeremiah that actually talks about those who live in the shadow of death. And I realized that David understood that for him, he does find himself there, but it doesn't matter how long he's there, he is walking through the shadow of death. It is not his destination, it's just a part of his path and a part of his itinerary. That was the thing that the children of Israel missed. And so the most significant thing I can share with you today is that you need to cultivate an attitude of gratitude. That irrespective of how things look right now, you need to come before the Lord with gratitude and thanksgiving. The children of Israel didn't realize that this was not their destination. That was the first mistake they made. But the second mistake was that they forgot too quickly. I don't know if you noticed that. Do you know that their complaining was exactly 3 days after they crossed over the Red Sea? It says, and they walked for 3 days and they could not find water and they started complaining. 3 days ago, what were they singing 3 days ago? Oh, bless the Lord, the horse and the rider, he has hurled into the sea. That was 3 days ago. They were writing hymns and new songs and praising and worshiping. 3 days later, they have forgotten about the power of their God. They are looking at God as though maybe you parted the Red Sea, but you had forgotten to see to it that we have water available to us in the desert on the other side. They forgot too quickly. The most critical thing you can do as you start this year is to cultivate an attitude of gratitude. Tell your neighbor, you need an attitude of gratitude. So if you're here and you're kind of in a neutral place, nothing exciting, nothing bad or nothing good has happened, you feel, oh, well, we're just entering a new year. You have to give thanks because you need to remember everything that God has done for you and how he has gotten you here. If you're here celebrating significant victory, then you must give thanks, telling the Lord, I recognize that my victories were not in my power. But if you're here and you feel like you're in Mara, you're in a place of sorrow or bitterness, you're in a place maybe of grief, you're in a place of significant financial constraint, even in that moment, you're in a space of emotional brokenness or brokenness in your mental health, even in that place, you need to come and give thanks, recognizing that God intervenes as he did for the children of Israel. But that even if the intervention doesn't come, you're not at your destination and God has a plan for you. Tell your neighbor, you need an attitude of gratitude. And so we're going to have an open mic time this morning and we just want to hear some testimonies. And we might not be able to hear from everyone, but we just want to create an opportunity for you to come and say, God has been good to me. And my prayer is that for those of you in Victory, we'll have some people come and share some stories out of Victory. My prayer is that for you who hadn't actively thought about it, that as you're listening to this, you're seeing specific things that you absolutely need to be thankful for. But my prayer is also that even if you're here and it's a tough day for you for whatever reason, that you'll still find the grace and the courage to say, God has been good to me even as I still wait for my miracle. The lesson I learned from this story is that if I don't praise God before the parting of the Red Sea, there's no guarantee that I will after. If I can't thank God before the miracle has come, there's no guarantee that I will thank him after. If I'm saying I will be grateful the day you provide every need that I have, that's the day I will praise you and I'm waiting for it. When it comes, there's no guarantee. It had happened for the children of Israel. They had gotten their wildest dreams. Their prayers had been answered. They had been slaves and now they were free. And 3 days after the greatest miracle, one of the greatest miracles in the Bible, they were already complaining. That's why you need to cultivate an attitude of gratitude. Tell your neighbor you need an attitude of gratitude. So I'm going to invite us, Pastor Alain. I need some guidance on the microphones. So we have some mics here next to this stand. I don't know if we're getting any other mics closer to the front. Oh, there we are. Ah, all right. So these amazing ladies are going to walk around and they'll bring the microphone to you. I'm going to create a bit of a protocol. This is how we do this. We do this every year on the last Sunday or the first Sunday of the year. You're going to share your testimony. I want you to keep it brief. I want you to keep it under 2 minutes. But when you end your testimony, I want you to end with these words. Give thanks to the Lord for he is good and his mercies endure forever. And the rest of us will help you conclude that statement. And for those of you watching online, let me invite you, just put your testimony, list everything. It can't be too much. Go into the comment section and write as much as you need to so that we can celebrate God's goodness together. All right, so I'm actually told, when you come to share your testimony, you come to the front rather than the mic coming to you, and then you'll be given the mic from the front. So let me ask, you want to come and give thanks to the Lord? This is your moment. We want to celebrate the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Amen? All right. Loading. Come on, let's celebrate evangelical poet. You can just share from right there.
Awesome. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Praise God. Praise God again. So for me, last year was quite an interesting year. I was almost giving up on church at the beginning of last year. And my sister told me to go and try her church. And if I like it, I can keep going to it. So I went to the church. It was Mavuno Lifeway. My sister stays at Kahawa West. So I went and tested Mavuno and I was like, "Weh, kuna freedom kwa hii church. People are not pretending to be holier than they actually are. They are watching a sermon on TV. This is against everything I've been taught. But this is also the freedom I needed." And I was like, as I go back to school, I was studying in Kenya Math. As I go back to school, if I get a church like this, their branch, I will go and be a part of it. Because I wanted that space to feel free and be myself. I didn't want to pretend anymore that I'm something that I'm not in church. And I went back to Kenya Math. I was living in South B within the school. And then tukaenda kutafuta church, me and my 3 friends. And then tukaenda Captain's Terrace, tukakuta walihama. And then we had to pay for an Uber to go back to CID after someone in Boxsters on IG and told us they had relocated. So Mavuno for me was one of the biggest things that God did last year. And hakuachia hapo. Last year I also got to spend time with Christians who actually have fun. Like, these people go out and they don't have to drink alcohol, but they have fun. Unaget. Because the community I come from Kitale. Nile place yenye lazima uvae official, like there is a way holy people that are going to heaven look like, and I didn't look like it. So for me, Mavuno was a big deal. And then, nini, I'm grateful to God that 2018 I quit statistics, but last year I graduated in something that I'm passionate about. I'm a journalist graduate of KMC right now. Woo. And
yeah. Come on.
I'm really grateful to God.
Amen.
So, ulisema tunamaliza na?
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever.
So let's say it together. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
His love endures forever. Come on, let's celebrate him. Awesome, 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 awesome. All right, I'm going to need you to come quickly so that we don't... Time. Karibuni, karibuni. Who's going next? Give thanks to the Lord. All right, let's celebrate her. She comes to the front. Yeah. Scovia, maybe you could actually stand here so that they just come. Okay. Let's celebrate Kezia. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Mavuno.
Happy New Year.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Well, it's good to be here. I don't know where to begin, but let me just begin by saying that it's taken me years to just, and I've never stood here to say, and I've been in this church for quite a while. That year that has just ended, the devil wanted me out. Like literally, he wanted me out. He attempted to out me, but for God. So I'll start by saying that I think the beginning of this year, we had a gathering in this church, and one of the things that we did before the end of the gathering, Pastor Emma asked us to get into the a neighboring place, this estate around here, and we were just going to, you know, evangelize. And that was something that I hadn't done before. And my friend and I, Janet, we were just walking. I remember when people were paired, Pastor James called me and Janet, and we were just speaking about something that he had had the Lord talk to him about me. And so we were left by the rest of the people. So we left a bit late, and we walked, my friend Janet and I haven't seen her, and we walked around this place, and I think we got two ladies saved that day. It was amazing. And we left fired up, and we decided we are going to evangelize, we're going to do this thing. And I think it was February. And within that month, I think I led three ladies to Christ within where I live. And I was excited. I was excited about that. So March 10th, I wake up, normal day. My son had just come from school. I was making breakfast for him, and I decided that let me just get some few things that I needed from the shop in our estate. And as I was walking back from the shop, I just fell. And looking back, I see a truck coming after me. A huge truck that I just left from the shop where I was taking a few things for my... And I saw me out. I saw me dead. I literally saw me, you know, just going. And I called Jesus. Like, literally, I was saying, Jesus, my children are not going to be woken up and be told that... I was calling Jesus, but in my mind, I was thinking, honey, those kids are going to be woken up and be told that their mother has died like this. My husband had just traveled out of town, so I was, well, so in a split second, I saw my left foot hanging on a tire of the vehicle, well, of that truck. It was a water bozer that belongs to one of the estate people there. And it stopped. I don't know what stopped it, but it stopped. But my foot looked like mincemeat. Literally, it looked like mincemeat. My favorite, I don't know if you have favorite hands, favorite foot. I have a favorite foot, and it's my left foot. Mm. And it looked like mincemeat. Mm. And I don't know. Some people say that I was picked from under the truck. I don't know what happened in that moment. But, well, I was saved by some people and I was taken, I was rushed to the hospital near there, and I think for a few days I was there and long story short, my foot was almost starting to rot, and I spent almost a month in hospital, and in that time the devil followed me there. I had three surgeries during that time. And the last surgery, I remember Pastor James and Pastor Dorcas came to see me in the hospital, and my prayer was like, I had been telling God, I can't have grafting. I have had enough pain. I have this wound. I don't want another wound. And when they asked me, how do we pray for you? I told them, may God heal that skin. I want a new skin. Can you surprise these doctors? Because I've told them I don't want this. And they agreed with me. You know what? He didn't grow the skin. Well, he didn't grow the skin, but well, I got the grafting. I'm well.
Amen.
And I'm just standing here to say that the Lord has healed me in a way that I can't explain. I am just so overwhelmed by the goodness of the Lord.
Amen.
As the last surgery that I was being done, the doctors told me later, I think the day after, that I reacted to a drug and that I was going, my pressure shot up, and they discovered that I wasn't breathing, and I, you know, and they had to intubate me, and they had to intubate me. And the devil was following me even in the theater. But tell you what, I'm here to say that Lord
leader.
Well, yes, he fought for me. And that day that I was being, the day that 10th, March 13th, my firstborn son was sitting his KCSE exams. And I remember wondering, so will he come for my funeral or will he sit for his exam? In that split second, I tell you what, God did it for him. He got a straight A. He's in school, he's joined college. And I stand here to say that, oh my God, he's amazing. He has done amazing things. Oh, I'm grateful. So very grateful.
Amen.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
His love endures forever. I have been advised by Pastor Lane, there's a way we could move a little faster. If you could just come to the front, so that all we will do is pass on the mic to the next person. That way we can move a little faster. Thank you, Pastor Kezia, for sharing that. God bless you. Let's celebrate Kezia. Awesome. Karibu sana. All the time. God is good. Maybe you can try switching mics if that one's having a problem. So you can introduce yourself so we can get to know you, and then share your testimony.
My name is Abby Bright Odai. Basically, I'm going to go straight to the point. God has been faithful all my life. Genuinely speaking, I am an orphan for over 20-something years now, and I can tell you that God has been taking good care of me for the last 25 years of my entire life. So. I grew up in a children's home through Empowering Loves International. Apparently, Mavuno have been there. But yeah, it's been a testimony of God constantly being there for me. So around 2021, I went to Saudi Arabia to do a little bit of research and be able to see what's happening there and understand what's happening in probably Riyadh and all that kind of thing. So it's pretty much really, really tough, because I was there for approximately 3 months and I could see a lot of, you know, tough situations going on around, and the manager looked at me and said, Abby, you don't belong here. You belong somewhere not here, maybe in the UK, but you don't belong to this country and you have to go back. And apparently Arabs don't like people who are intimidating, so I was pretty much really, really intimidating, and I'm very sassy by nature. So the manager looked at me and said, you're gonna have to go back to your country. So I came back around December of 2021. That was immediately after losing my grandmother. And so Last year, January, I told the Lord that I'm going to ask you to direct me to the right people, the right position, and probably just give me the right opportunity for me. Around February, I'm in consultancy of PR and communications. Basically, I build organizations and be able to create publicity and visibility. So I ask God to give me a purpose. And so around February, I got an international organization based in the USA. They have a hospital in Eldoret, and they basically needed a PR and communication kind of consultancy for 6 months. So what happened is they had a really, really serious crisis. So my job was to ensure that they have patients. They're struggling for like approximately three years. So God did an amazing thing. Because immediately after 6 months, they had patients filling the hospital. So I know it's crazy, but I was just beginning out. And there was a big, big organization based in the US now. I'm dealing with USA, I'm dealing with Empowering Lives, I'm dealing with BIM Kenya. These are international organizations that I'm able to do consultancy for them. So within 6 months, they had patients. At around December, I heard the Lord telling me, Abby, I need you to start your own company. So I did, Skyline Public Relations Company. So right now, I'm currently running the company. And I think God is faithful. When I say faithful, I mean faithful because I didn't have the resources, but God gave me the right people at the right time. So everybody who gave me a service, it was for free. So at around September, I started the organization running in Eldoret, doing small consultancy and all that. Now, this is where God does things. When I came here, we had Pastor M. For over years, I've been struggling to be in a church, a place of worship, and there's a lot of disconnect out there with the real world. So basically, I just came here to have that session with Pastor M. I think where I was seated, I only told God, can you please put the person sitting right next to me, somebody who's going to make my day better and probably just help me be able to learn and be able to get to know you better from this person that's going to sit. I was seated there and I had no one. The seats were empty. And a very, very senior person, apparently he was being talked about at the pulpit, was sitting right next to me. And I didn't know him. I just introduced myself and it was like, my name is Abby, blah, 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 and all that kind of introduction. When I walked out, he was like, Abby, can you do consultancy for me? I was like, whoa, you have not seen my CV. I have not told you anything. I have not done an interview. I have just told you what I do. He's like, no. God, what do you mean? And he's like, can you go back and pray about it? And then you can come back and tell me. I'm like, this is different for me because, usually you ask for a CV, you ask for so many serious questions. But this person's looking at me and says, God has called you for Africa. I'm like, oh, this is too big. Because I prayed and I told God, you're going to have to prepare me for this. And I can tell you today, I have the job.
Amen.
Woo. So yes, amen. I love the Lord deeply within my heart. Mm. And I'm truly grateful for 2022. God has been carrying me along. And I actually look forward to future together with the Lord.
Amen.
So we're going to say it together. Uh-huh. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good and his love endures forever.
Thank you so much, Abby.
Praise the Lord, church.
Amen.
My name is Leah and I have a short testimony. Over the years, I've always wanted to stand here and testify of something that I've been trusting God for so long over the years. And in 2022, God did it for me and I'm here to testify. So I've been looking for a job for the last 7 years. And this year, 7 years, guys, 7 years of applying and getting those sorry kind of emails. Mm. But March 2022, God answered that prayer. Amen. So I had promised him if he did that for me, I will come here and testify. Amen. Give thanks to the Lord for he is good.
And his love endures forever. Hey, God is good. Thank you so much, Leah. We thank God with you. Welcome, Pastor Jacob.
Praise God, church.
Amen.
I thank God. Pastor James is calling me pastor. I never knew whether that would be one of my titles, but I thank God. Last year, when we had gathering here, the Lord spoke to me in his own way. He gave me some ministry in the Swahili church. I didn't know what it was all about, but the Lord instructed me to move to the Swahili campus, and I was there. When I went there, I was giving assistance in the area of music. I was playing keyboard. And many a times when you play keyboard in a church, you are called kijana wa keyboard. So I've been serving there as a kijana wa keyboard, but the Lord
was still ministering to me and telling me that I have a space, I have some work in the Swahili campus. Just to go forward, there was some issues in the Swahili campus. I think the pastors know what was happening there. And I was in that space. I was praying for God's direction. And interestingly, I didn't know what to do there, but I was just there praying for that space, in that space. In the month of August, September, Reverend Cheche was actually the one who was in charge of that church, just called me and told me that he wants me to stand with him, which I did faithfully, but I did this from the position of kijana wa keyboard. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I was not ministering as a pastor. I was just doing what I was taught to do. And I think during the same time, there was a lot of teachings about honor. So what I did, I just honored him as a man of God. And interestingly, when he got to a space where he wanted to leave, I think he told me that I think Brother Jacob will be the one will be in charge of that church. I was like, I thought I was not the right person to do that. I was called by Pastor James, and he told me that Swahili Church, we are settled, we have settled, you are the one that shall be in charge of that church. It's something that struck me because all of my life, I just want to give a testimony. Wherever I've been going, wherever I've been working, people call me pastor.
Amen.
I don't call myself a pastor, but most of the times I used to resist people from calling me a pastor, telling them I'm not a pastor. They started calling me until I got used to it, and I decided, just because they are calling me a pastor and I don't have a church, let me just accept it for the sake of it. But I thank God, because I have been a runaway person, because I've been avoiding this title of being a pastor. It caught up with me at this age, and I receive it. I didn't know whether for such a time like this, I would be a pastor. I thank God for my flock.
Amen.
The Swahili campus, they are awesome people.
Amen.
I've been having a heart for the people who are kind of underprivileged. I think I'm comfortable working with them.
Amen.
And I thank God because I've taken the space, and I know that the Lord is doing something. And in this new year,
amen,
I tell you as a church, watch this space. The Lord God is going to lift people in the Swahili church. And most of them, they'll be a witness to the rest of the world.
Amen.
Give thanks to the Lord.
For he is good. His love endures forever. Come on, let's celebrate, Pastor Jacob.
I've given this testimony on behalf of the Swahili campus. And after this, we are moving to our space so that we may share our testimonies from there.
Amen.
God bless you.
Let's celebrate them one more time. For the people from Swahili, Pastor Jacob, this is not the first time he's saying that. He's been saying that to me. He's been saying, watch this space. And I'm so excited about what God will do in that space. And may every vision and every dream he has laid on your heart come to pass to the glory and honor of his name. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. I'm trying to represent the gender balance.
Thank you. Thank
you. A lot of women have been coming.
The meeting was becoming unconstitutional.
You know, they have been saying that the man child does not speak. So I'm going to speak on their behalf. My name is John Jiro. the Gateway DG lead. We've seen a lot respectively as DG members for Gateway. We've seen miracles happening.
Amen.
Within our member from each and every individual there. We've seen a lot of grace. In fact, we've collectively named it as the year of gratitude.
Amen.
We are very grateful.
Amen.
On a personal level, I've had immense gains in 2022. I've gotten so much love from God, grace, and immense blessings. I'm extremely grateful.
Amen.
Yes, so give thanks to the Lord.
For he is good, his love endures forever. Thank you so much for standing in the gap for us. I can see a testimony from our online audience. John Kigada says, I got a 50% scholarship to study for a mini MBA. Praise be to God. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good and his love endures forever. For our online audience, please put up your testimony. I can see Pastor Sachuma from all the way in Lusaka. Thank you for joining us this morning. Gabriel.
Thank you, Pasi. Good morning.
Morning.
Praise God.
Amen.
My name is Gabriel Amani. What I want to share today is a story that has been told to so many Pasis of this church. And I believe the Pasi knows about it. But what I want to start with is I'm here because of God. I'm alive because of God. Last year, in around March, I was involved in a very bad road accident. I was going for a job in Meru, and it so happened that the co-driver and the driver slept. I was the co-driver on the co-driver's seat. I didn't have my seat belt on, but we slept. In about 5 seconds, we veered off the road and we rolled 3 times. The windscreen was down and I found myself on the road. So being here is God. I actually survived with minor injuries. I just got a cut on my left arm, a very small one, and by evening it was already closing. So I'm here to share that God has been so faithful in my life. I want to thank God for being alive. And my second testimony is just before I got the accident, I'm an employee of Daystar University. I've also been studying there for quite some time. I joined Daystar University in 2014. But unluckily, the guardians who took me there passed on in 2015 and the other in 2017. So I was left still studying. I didn't know what to do. So many people in the village expected me to go back to the village. I'm from Mombasa, a place called Mariakani. So people expected me to go back and now continue hustling with my mom. But again, the Lord gifted me in production. I do graphics design and also do video production. So as I continued doing my freelancing, Daystar had a position for an assistant graphics designer. And one of the guys told me to try and apply. So I applied and then we got the job. So I did a job. I started the job in November last year and went on. No, it was in 2022, yeah, November. 2021, November, it's when I started. to the end of the year. So it has been a struggle getting my contract renewed and coming back. But I thank God that I got the contract renewed in early 2022. Then in that March, the same month that I got the accident, all the people who were on contract were sacked, were told to go home. So I didn't know what to do, and I really thank Pastor Maluki for being there for me, because we came and prayed together. And in just a week time, I got my job back. So I really thank God for that, that among all the people who were taken back, it was a guy without a degree who got back to the job.
Amen.
Hey, come on. And I'm also really want to thank God, because I want to put this in faith. My contract ended yesterday, mm-hmm. So I'm hoping that this coming week I'll get an extension of the same. Amen. And also I'm hoping to get back to class.
Amen.
So I really pray for that. And I also want to say thank you to God for allowing my mom to see this new year. She got really ill last week on the 25th. As we served here, my mom was calling me. No, I was not even called by my mom. I was called by my brother that my mom is really ill, that she couldn't even walk. And she couldn't even talk nor eat. But as we speak, I spoke with her yesterday. She was so jovial, and she's happy that she's in the new year. Thank you.
Amen.
So give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His
and
love
endures forever. Thank you thank so you. Much, Gabu. Gabu serves on the worship team, the services team, and we celebrate what God is doing in your life. Karibu.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God again.
Amen.
My name is Damaris Msaga. I joined Mavuno Church last year, April. So sometime in October, Pastor Jerry said we come with our documents to, if you eat your birth certificates, the CVs. I'd been looking for a job for a very long time. So I came here with my CVs, and I took a step of faith. We prayed with Pastor Elaine on a Sunday. And on Thursday, the same week, I got a call, report to work tomorrow morning.
Yes. Come on.
And I'm so grateful, and I give thanks to the Lord. I have so many things, but to say, so, but that was one of the biggest testimony I had to the close of the year, because to me, when I got that call, I was like, oh my God. Because I can't even remember when I did the interview.
Wow.
Yes.
Amen.
So I thank God for that.
Amen.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
His love endures forever. Amen. Amen. We'll be drawing to our close shortly. So if you really want to share your testimony, we want to hear it. I'm going to ask that you come closer to the front so that we can identify you. I want us to close with spending just a little time in prayer and making some declarations over this new year. Karibu. Good morning.
My name is Lynette Ojiambo. I fellowship at Mavuno Far East, Mavuno Mashariki Network. Today I'm fellowshipping with you, and I'm glad to be here. So, three testimonies. One, this year my son finished Standard 8 and Form 1 in the same year, and those are milestones that I have to celebrate. I know it has happened for many people, but Standard 8 and Form 1 are milestones. You guys get it. So,
amen.
And he's happy, he's whole, he's well. I bless the Lord for that. He's in a good school, and he went through Form 1 without any trouble. I'm really grateful. So again, this year, my parents were able to move into a house just here in Kitengela, which is why I'm here today, because I was visiting them. But the thing is, this house, they've been praying and trusting God to get it all their lives. It's my parents. They are like in their 60s. This is when they are getting their dream house. It was such a big thing. Yesterday, we were speaking with my mom, and she was saying the way my dad and literally teared down when he finally came into that house, because this is a childhood dream. You've prayed, you've trusted God that one day you'll be somewhere and you'll be able to build to this position, and he was able to do that. And I think the day they got in, I was again blessed of God to be able to be present, and just to be with them as we moved in, and therefore sit in a space where we knelt down together and prayed. And I think I was blessed to be able to represent my siblings and to represent the children as my parents were moving in into that space. And for me, why it's a testimony as well is the fact that we can wait. We can wait. There are so many of us who are waiting for things for God to fulfill. But in his own time, he makes everything beautiful.
Amen.
So again, it's a testimony because for my mom, this house, same house, had been delayed. It was something that would have been done in the year 2020. But then in the year 2020, my mom was diagnosed of cancer. So for 2 years, as a family, we were praying and trusting God that she'd be healed and she'd be doing well, and so that we can be able to move on. Mm. So 2 years later, 2022,
Amen.
She's healed. Mm. She's Amen. Not fully recovered 100%, mm-hmm. but she's getting there.
Amen.
She's able to stay in that house. Mm. And you know, they joke that because they insisted on building a maisonette with stairs, mm. they say that all their lives they always wanted to come down the stairs and go upstairs in the bedroom. Amen. And we couldn't get it, but every time they say that, we understand it. Yeah. And so my mom, she literally struggles to climb the stairs, but she said, these were the childhood dreams of my heart, and Amen. The Lord has done it for me.
Amen.
And so they are doing it, and I bless the Lord for that. Mm. Then again, I normally host a church in my house, a yep. home church. Mm. At Far East, we do home churches. So one of the home churches is in my house. Mm. So this year, unfortunately, we lost one of our church members. But that's where the story is. It was a young child. He was about 9 years old. And this child started coming to church in the time of COVID because we invited the neighborhood people, and they were living upstairs, up of my house. Yeah. So they would say they are going to church with a sibling, and they would come downstairs mm. to my house to church. So by God's design, we lost him sometime in September, October there. But the thing is, it was just the child who used to come to church. He has a sibling, him and the sibling, but the parents were not plugged in anywhere in the church space. So when the incident happened, it was an opportunity for us to step in and minister for them. And so we're able to go there and represent Christ in their space and be the church that carried them throughout this entire season of grief. To burying their son, to even having the funeral done down in Kisumu, and thanking God for Pastor George and Pastor Milton, my pastors, who were present, and the whole church actually, the whole entire Far East church, were present, and we were there for them. These guys, without that church being there, or without us being present, they would not have had a church to be able to move them forward.
Amen.
Maybe they would have gotten on, but this came with ease. And we came in as the church of this child. So why, again, is it a testimony? It's a testimony for me because I think it is this year that I finally understood why God allowed me to have a church.
Amen.
In that space. Mm. Like, it hits you so hard when you realize maybe it was for this one family. Because I've had it there, and sometimes you wonder, why do you have a church here? And people ask. But this year I was able to put that one answer.
Amen.
That it was because of this child that you were able to stand for the family that was so broken. And today they come to church, the mother Amen. Gave her life to Christ, Amen. And we bless the Lord for that. So give thanks to the Lord, church, for he is good.
His love endures forever. Wow, let's celebrate her. Our Mavuno Church Far East is one of our Mavuno campuses. Their vision is to plant, 1,000 house churches? I really love that vision. I'm excited to see what God will do in that space. So we celebrate you and we honor you and we thank you for leading. Asante sana. Karibu.
Praise God.
Amen.
I would hope to be a testimony appropriate. I have a kitenge lying somewhere in the house.
These young people.
So I'm so excited to be here. As I was there in the camera, I just go and say it. So when I say last year, it's 2021.
Eh? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 2021, I lost my dad. My dad was my best friend. He was an amazing father. He was an amazing guy. So I lost my father. And, you know, it was that time. And, I was in a very ugly space. I was in a very ugly place. In 2022, January, I moved to Athi River. In February, moved to Athi River. And I was with my sister. My sister told me, "Bethe Mavuno, I could tour up a mahali. You know, I could come and let's go together." So I came to Mavuno. It's been a while since I've gone to a church. And I came into Mavuno. And I remember after that, I've done film. I've started film and television production. And I graduated and I was first in my class, but not the point. I was not doing something with that. So when I came to Mavuno, Hillcity, as I was listening to the sermon and they talked about serving, immediately I went back there. I remember I met Njoki, and Njoki introduced me to Elaine, and I told him, I'm into camera operations and I'm into visual audio and I would love to serve. And they were so excited and I was like, wow, why are these people so excited? You know, and you know, it's a space I want to be in. I thought there would be a process and, you know, an audition or an interview. So the next Sunday I was on camera. The next Sunday I was on camera and I started serving, never looked back. But you know, I loved it because, you know, I do what I love and I love doing it. And you know, I never look back, but then I was still stuck. This is 2022 now. Mm. I was stuck. I remember there was a time I woke up in the morning and I just, you know, before I get there, I just loved how I would go to Elaine, or I go to Pastor Elaine, sorry, now, or I go to Pastor Maluki. And you know, they would just ask me, how do you want me to pray with you? And I really didn't understand that. Like, I'm coming, I'm telling you about me, I want solutions. I want solutions. I was never really understanding where they were coming with this. And I woke up one day and I was just like, you know, just go talk to him. Just go and talk to him. Just go and talk to him. And I came to the office. It was on family night. And I came to the office. And amazingly, Pastor M, our senior pastor, was in the office, and you know, I was just pushed to go in, and I went in, and I sat down and I talked to him, and he listened. I actually went in and I just asked for. He was on his laptop. He's busy. He was preparing for the family night. And I was like, can I have like 2 minutes of your time? And he put aside his laptop, and he sat back, and he said, "Sit down." And I talked to him, and I talked to him, and I talked to him, and he was like, "Okay, I'll see. I'll talk to a friend, and you know, I'm not promising anything." Came out, and after that, there was a day I met Pastor James in the washroom, and I was like, "You know, I really need to talk to you." And I talked to him, and he said, "Okay, don't worry. If you've talked to Pastor M, it's gonna be okay." And after that, I continued serving diligently, and I love it, and I love it. And right now, I used to have a church, but I used to call it a home church because that is where I went to Sunday school, and that is where I went to my teens classes, and that's where my parents took me to. But this is a home. It's a church, but it's a home. And it's my home church. And I am blessed because a 360 happened once I stepped into those entrances. Once I stepped into that gate and I stepped into that place and I came and sat here and I've never looked. And I love every single person I work with, I associate with,
amen,
I talk with. It's just amazing vibes. It's just Now I understand why you will talk to somebody and they will tell you, how can I pray with you? Because something happened just the other day, and I left the house coming to Mavuno to look for somebody to pray with. And I found George, and you know, we prayed together, and I felt amazing after that, and now I understand. And I thank God for Mavuno, and I thank God for a home church.
Amen.
Because it happened.
Amen.
And it's going to happen better.
Amen.
And I give thanks to the Lord, for
he is good, and his love endures forever. Let's celebrate Chris. Chris serves, is currently going through our internship here at Mavuno Hillcity. We have a couple of testimonies from our online audience on YouTube. Esther says, God has been gracious and faithful in 2022. He has provided, protected, and grown us in the grace of giving. Caroline says, my testimony is from the 27th of December when we were coming back home from upcountry. We were almost involved in an accident. I give thanks to God for his love endures forever. We are all well. We thank God with you, Carol and Esther. The next one is from Winnie Ruto. I thank God for his faithfulness in 2022. My husband got a stroke in April, and that paralyzed his entire left side. After 2 surgeries, 8 months of physio and occupational therapy, he is healed and doing great. Winnie, we thank God with you and Mike and your family. We give thanks to the Lord, for he is good and his love endures forever. Karibu.
Right. Very good morning and happy new year.
Happy new year.
Very good. My name is Joseph. Kingdom entrepreneurs.
Amen.
And just to let you know that with God, all things are possible.
Amen.
Being an entrepreneur, things, one of the best things. And there are things I can share, there are things I cannot share. But what can I say? God has favored us as kingdom entrepreneurs in the bee industry and has favored us with innovations. We are only 2 years old, but we have done things that have never been done before in the bee keeping industry.
Amen.
It is not by might,
not
it is
by
not
power,
by power, but it has been by the Spirit of God. Just inspirations coming our way, and they are not small achievements. This year we won an award. We won an award and a very special award. You can imagine being selected from a pool of 2,200 business contestants as a winner of an award. And this is something you've only done for 2 years. Is that amazing? So we have really experienced the grace of God.
Amen.
And the favor of God in that bee industry. We invented some concrete hives, and beyond that, we have a farm in Shimoni. That's where my testimony really comes at this time. As an entrepreneur, people put in their money. I was given responsibilities. We went into Shimoni, where our dad gave us some huge tract of land, which is a forest land. We put in a lot of money. Bees came. At some point, we had over 50 hives and plus with bees. But can you believe it? For 2 solid years, so much bees, so much hives, not even a drop of honey. Not even a drop of honey. It was weird. We prayed, we fasted, we researched, we did all we could. But then, amazingly, God answered in a big way. And we have just made another invention, which I can't talk much about, because in the process of being, protected. And now we have lots and lots of honey coming from the same place.
Amen.
And it is just God leading us to tweak something small, and blah, the heavens were just open.
Amen.
So I would just encourage entrepreneurs here that with God, all things are possible. For those of us who are in the kingdom and are entrepreneurs, God is very much concerned about your business because it is his business.
Amen.
So give thanks to the Lord.
For he is good
and his love
endures forever. Thank you so much. Madhari, I'm going to allow that we share two more testimonies from the front because we need to get into a time of prayer. I'll guide us on how to testify from there, and then we'll get into a time of prayer. Karibu.
Hello. Good morning, church.
Morning.
My name is Eric. I'm an Adventist, by the way. And I come here partially when I come to Nairobi, but I'm from Bondo.
Karibu sana.
Yeah. So this is my church too.
Amen.
I'm grateful. Welcome. I've come here to give a testimony because the first time I came to this church was back in 2018 December, when we just moved here. And we prayed here. I usually sit somewhere there, and I witnessed God's favor. And when I prayed, immediately the year ended and I got a job in Mombasa, and that was courtesy of the prayer that I prayed in this church.
Amen.
Personally, I'm not so much into the church because I was brought up in the church, but just got upset about some things in the church, how they run the church in my place. And then I stopped going, but after some, when I usually come here, I usually feel the presence of God. I usually feel fulfilled by the power and the grace of God. And I'm grateful for that. That's why when I come here, I feel like I should be part of you each and every time I'm here.
Amen.
I'm just grateful. My testimony is that I pray that the same way God has always been fulfilling and giving me an opportunity to more and more blessings when I come to this church, I pray that just like 2022 was a blessed year for me, I believe 2023 will also be a blessed year for me as I'll be going to take my neck examination come March. Pray for me.
Amen.
Thank you so much.
Amen. Thank you so much. I didn't get your name. Eric.
I'm Eric Obara.
Eric, thank you so much. Let's celebrate Eric. And this is your church. Did you hear him say, I sit somewhere there? Surely, if you even own a chair in this church, it is your church. Hapa ni nyumbani, welcome. We thank God for blessing you while you're here with us. Yes, let's do it together.
Okay. Me. Please wait.
Uh-huh.
Me and my family, we give thanks to the Lord.
For he is good. His love endures forever. Thank you so much, Eric. Let's celebrate him. Thank you so much.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God again.
Amen.
Happy New Year, by the way. I've not said Happy New Year to anyone. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
My name is Wanjiko. I have been fellowshipping here since last year in August when we moved close by. And my coming to church here has really nourished me spiritually. And my testimony is that last year, I ran a business and it was really low and finances were not really good. But God has provided in ways I couldn't think about. And my biggest testimony last year is that I was able to attend the Fearless Summit, which is something that I needed, but I couldn't pay for. But someone amongst you sponsored some of us, and for that I'm really, truly grateful. Because during the summit, God spoke to me in regards to the passion that I have and the purpose that he has for me, and it was affirmed during the Fearless Summit. And I remember when I left here, on my way home, a lady where I stopped by to buy my home groceries called me and told me that I feel the Spirit of God telling me that he has a space for you in the media space and he will use you to minister in that space. And since that is the same thing I was getting through the Fearless Summit, I was like, God is affirming me and he will lead me in his own ways. And for me to have attended the Fearless Summit through the sponsorship, that for me is something that I'm truly grateful for. And God really provided for me in that entire year because I was really struggling financially. So for that, I am grateful.
Amen.
And together we say, we
give thanks to the Lord, for he is good
and his love endures forever.
Let's celebrate her. Thank you so much.
I want you to turn to your neighbor, and I'm going to give you, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, and I want you to share a testimony. You haven't had a chance to come to the front. Just share what you're grateful for. Let them know how God has been good to you in the year 2022. And when they share, you give thanks to the Lord for His good and His love endures forever, and then you go back to the next, to your neighbor. You allow them to share after you have shared. Wow, we serve a loving and a good God. A couple more testimonies from our online audience. Thank you so much for worshiping with us. Lungowe, a good friend of ours from Zambia. Some of you know that my family and I lived in Zambia. She says, I testify of God's goodness because He provided for my family and I throughout the year, and He made a miraculous way for my university tuition fees to be paid for last year. As for this year, I'm so grateful for His continued faithfulness and optimistic that He will do it again. We thank God for 2022, and He's the same way He was faithful in 2022, Lungowe, He will continue to be faithful in 2023. Eugene Agwe, you testify, is a blessed year for me. I found a church in Mavuno, restoration of my family after 3 years. After 3 years, his family was restored, giving my life to God, getting baptized, going through Andoa. We thank God for you, Eugene, and for the things that He's doing in your life and in the life of your family. And together we say, give thanks to the Lord, for He is good and His love endures forever. I had a pastor who's one of my mentors, share from the scripture we read today, which is when the children of Israel had just gotten across the Red Sea, and they sang this incredible song of praise. And they are testifying about how, God has hurled the horse and its rider into the sea. And for sure, it's a powerful miracle. But this pastor challenged me because he said, what if they had done their praising before the miracle? Wouldn't that have been even more profound? What if the song had been even before the Red Sea was parted? What if they had already been singing and saying that, God, you're going to part the Red Sea because we have seen what you have done in Egypt, and we have seen every miracle it has taken for us to come the far that we have come. And so it's a challenge that I try to take on in my life, and I try to give God in advance. Tell your neighbor, give God thanks in advance. Tell your neighbor, thanks in advance. And so I want you to rise to your feet because we're going to spend a couple of minutes praying, and then we'll say some declarations, and then we shall, you know, go to have our celebrations for the day. For some of you, even in the testimony, you know, I heard this from Gabu. He said, I'm trusting God to get back into school. We've had the same from Lungo, where we've had, Eric, who's trusting God for some neck examinations. That we, while we have things we are grateful for in 2022, we have things we are trusting God for in 2023. And so I want to give you a moment to do that thing that I learned from this mentor of mine. His name is Reverend Mulandi from Nairobi Baptist Church. And I want you to thank God for the miracles that are coming. I want you to thank God for the things you're trusting Him for, to declare that in faith, you know He loves you enough that He will give you the blessing, that He is going to part the Red Sea, that in the same way He has brought you all the way from Egypt, He had not gotten confused and He's not lost. He's not now trying to figure out how do we make our way through here. And so I'm going to give you just 2 minutes. Just speak to the Lord this morning. Tell Him, I thank you because you will be faithful in 2023. Tell Him, I thank you because of the breakthrough I will experience. Tell Him, I thank you for open doors. Thank you for promotion. Thank you for provision. Thank you for my family, that you will bless us, you will increase us. And just declare His goodness. Declare that in the same way He has been good so far, you understand and you believe that He will continue to be good. Come on, just raise up your voice in prayer this morning. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. Don't just wait to give thanks after the miracle. If you can't give thanks now, there's no guarantee that you will give thanks after. Lord and our King, we choose to come in thanksgiving by faith. We thank you that it shall be well with us in 2023. We thank you because you have provided for our every need. That even if we are in Mara right now, that's a space that we are, that's what our life feels like. We thank you because the oasis of Elim is right ahead. That there are springs of water, there's provision for every resource, and a meeting of every need is available to us. You have already made provision. You're just guiding us through the journey to the place where our blessing is. So we thank you because you have blessed us. We thank you for every need that we are presenting to you in 2023, because every need represents an opportunity for a miracle. And so we thank you for every miracle you have already performed and made provision for. We thank you for every testimony that we will share from this day, that we will testify of your goodness, your protection, your love, your favor upon us in every way, that we will come before you and experience your goodness. We thank you in advance. We declare that you have been good. We declare that you continue to be good, and that you will be good to us in 2023. And we look forward, we come with anticipation and expectation as we look forward just to entering your goodness and experiencing your favor and your love. In Jesus' name we pray. And all God's people said, amen, amen, amen. I spent some time in prayer just asking God what kind of declarations should we make as we enter into this year. And for those of you who are here last night, we did these declarations. I want us to make declarations in three areas of our lives. The first is obedience and alignment to God's will. I feel that this is a thing that God is calling us to in 2023, a wholehearted commitment to Him and to following Him. And so I want us to declare by faith. Maybe if you've never done this before, the Word of God tells us that the power of life and death is in the tongue. God has given us spiritual authority. And in the same way He spoke and things were created, we can speak and things will become as we speak them by faith and prophetically in alignment to His will. And so that's what we want to do. And so I want us to make declarations concerning these three things. And the first is obedience and alignment to His will. Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 says, seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. I don't know if it will be possible to put the map purity. That will make it a little bit easier. If not, then I'll just lead you guys and you can say them after me. All right. The foundation for God's blessing is covenant. And the covenant that God seeks to make with us, in the Bible it says over and over, and they shall be my people and I shall be their God. John chapter 1 verse 12 says, and to as many as believed, he gave the right to become children of God. So even before we make these declarations, before we speak these blessings that we're trusting God for by faith, if you're here and you're not in relationship with God, if you're not under that covenant, I wanna give you a moment to just give your life to the Lord. I'm not gonna take too long, so I'm gonna just ask that you shoot your hand right up and we can pray together with you. And then that can, the foundation for the declarations is your own relationship with God. Is there someone like that? You need to start by making that decision. You need to make this decision on the first day of 2023, and this is how you start your year. Is there someone like that? Don't be shy, don't be afraid. I see that hand. Let's celebrate our sister on that side. Is there someone else? I can see, just keep your hand up. Our guest experience team will bring you a slip of paper. Is there someone else that you want to make this decision as you enter into the new year? You want to commit your life to Jesus for the first time, or to recommit your life because you know you haven't been walking in relationship with him. All right, I'm going to lead you through our prayer, my sister. And for those of you who are born again, as we say this prayer, I'm going to ask that you say it together with me, that you join our sister in saying this declaration of faith. Dear Jesus, I thank you for your love. I confess that I have sinned. And this morning, I turn away from my sin and I commit my life to you. I receive the blessing of your forgiveness for every sin in my life. And I commit to a life of obedience and submission to your will. And I receive the gift of your Holy Spirit to lead me and guide me. In Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Let's celebrate our sister one more time. We thank the Lord for the things that he's doing. So this is the first declaration. All right. Coming. All right, say this after me. I declare that I will align to you, Holy Spirit, and to your instruction for me in 2023. This is the second declaration. I commit to obedience and to repentance where I fall short. I'm going to give you 60 seconds just to pray for yourself and just invite the Holy Spirit of God and to affirm that commitment. Just tell the Lord, I'm looking to honor you in 2023. I won't be following, I won't be leading myself. I will be following you. I'll be seeking to do everything that you lead and guide me. So come on, just take a moment and ask the Lord and make this commitment to the Lord. It's a commitment of dedication. It's a commitment to honor God and to obey him. Our Lord, you're calling us to seek first your kingdom and to obey you fully and wholeheartedly. And this is my commitment. And these are our commitments here as we stand before you, that we are declaring we will honor you, we will obey you, that our greatest pursuit and the greatest desire of our lives will be to bring glory and honor to your name. And we thank you for every blessing that will come from our submission to your will. In Jesus' name, and all God's people said, amen, amen, amen. The second area that we're going to make declarations concerning is, I want us to make some declarations concerning commitment and steadfastness. Job chapter 13 verse 15 says, Job in his hardest moment said, though he slay me, yet will I trust in him. And I just felt that God is calling us to that kind of faith. The kind of faith that says, I'm not in this just for the good times. I'm not only following you when you answer all my prayers and give me every blessing I ask for. Though he slay me, yet will I serve him. yet will I put my hope in him, yet will I praise him. Those were the declarations of Job. And so I want us to declare, to make some declarations of commitment and steadfastness, commitment to God and steadfastness in your faith and in your service to God. I don't know if we've managed. All right, there we are. Let's say it together. I declare that I will be steadfast in my faith and in my commitment to him, no matter what comes my way. Let's go to the second one. I declare that even when I cannot see your blessing in my life, I will honor you, I will serve you, I will wait on you, and I will trust that you are with me and blessing me. Come on, just pray over yourself and make this declaration and this commitment to the Lord. I just declare that this year I am following God, that I will not be distracted by difficulty. I will not be distracted by hardship. I will not be distracted by any moment of Mara, any season of walking through the bitter waters, that I will be steadfast in my love and in my commitment to God. Come on, just speak to the Lord this afternoon and make these declarations over him. For those of you who are following us online, you can make these declarations over yourself as well and just continue to make these commitments and to enter into these covenant promises of following God and serving him. Our Lord and our King, we thank you. We thank you that even when we can't see your hand, even when we can't see the blessing, like the children of Israel before they got to Elim, even when we can't see it, we can trust your heart. We can trust that your intentions toward us are good. We can trust that you have made provision for our blessing and our breakthrough. Even when to us it feels like it's taking too long and we've gone too far, we thank you that you're still with us, loving us and blessing us. And so I pray for every single one of us the grace to be steadfast in our faith, that no matter what the enemy throws our way, that we will have a testimony like Keziah, who has testified today that even when I was in hospital, the enemy was following me, but I know she was still waiting on the Lord. She was still putting her hope and her trust in you, and she can testify that you have come through for her. Even when you didn't answer the prayer for the skin to grow back, you still healed her and given her the blessing that she desired. I pray that this will be the posture of our hearts, a posture of commitment no matter what, that we will declare like Job did. We will praise you irrespective of where we are, to the glory and honor of your name, in Jesus' name. And all God's people said, amen, amen. And the third and final declaration has to do with understanding and revelation. As I was reading through the scriptures last year, I just got a burden for understanding. And when we're going to read through the New Testament together, and you find that they talk a lot about understanding. And Paul prays for the churches. He writes when he says, I pray that you will get greater understanding. I pray for a spirit of wisdom. I pray for revelation. And it has become something that I desire and that I feel that God desires for us to have. And so we're going to make some declarations that are based on Ephesians chapter 1 verse 16 to 19, which is a prayer that Paul was making over the church in Ephesus. You can read it after this. And these are the declarations. I declare that I will, okay, let's say it together, one, two, go. I declare that I will seek you faithfully and diligently in prayer, fasting, and reading your word. I declare that as I seek you daily for direction, I will operate in understanding and revelation. I declare that I will enter into every door that you open for me and receive every blessing that you send my way. That I will be attentive to your direction, Holy Spirit. Come on, just pray for yourself and just pray that God will give you discernment. Ask God that your spirit will be sensitive in this new year, that you will be finding that you did things and said things that when you look at them afterwards, you can tell only the Holy Spirit of God could have led you to that action or to that word or that a specific thing that you have done. Lord and our King, as we seek to honor you in 2023,
We pray that you will do for us what Paul was praying, the Apostle Paul prayed for the church at Ephesus. That you will give us a spirit of wisdom and revelation, a spirit of knowledge and understanding, as other versions call it. I pray that we will operate in divine ideas. I pray that we will operate, Lord, with just above any understanding that is physical or natural. That Holy Spirit of God, you will heighten our discernment. That we will be able to say, the Holy Spirit of God instructed me in this way or in that way. That we will look at decisions we made and we will recognize we did not have the wisdom for them. It was just your Spirit leading us internally and guiding us into those spaces. We thank you that in this new year, we are going to walk into every blessing that you have spoken over us as a church. We thank you for the blessing of ease and acceleration. We thank you for the blessing of spiritual fitness. We thank you for the blessing of family impact. We thank you that our Lord and our God, as we enter into this year, you're going to lead us and guide us into every single one of those blessings. That we will not miss anything that you have intended for us, because you will cause us to be sensitive, to understand what you're saying, and to follow you to the places you call us to go, to the glory and to the honor of your name. And now, Lord, I speak a blessing over your children. Let me ask that you stretch your hands out in front of you. I speak a blessing over your children now. I declare that you are blessed in 2023. I declare that every area of your life is blessed in Jesus' name. I declare that no intention of the enemy will prevail over you in Jesus' name. My Father and my God, I speak a blessing of life and health over your sons and daughters. I speak over these who are here in this hall. I speak over those who are watching online. I declare that you are blessed in Jesus' name. I declare that in this year you will enter into the blessings that God has in store for you, and that this will be a year filled with testimonies of his goodness and of amazing ways that he has used you to bring impact to the lives of many people in Jesus' name. I thank you for ease and acceleration this year. I thank you for spiritual growth to levels that we have never experienced and imagined ourselves operating in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I thank you that our families will be transformed this year. I thank you that we are the people that you desire and you're calling to use for that level of impact and transformation. I speak the peace of God upon you. I speak the joy of the Lord upon you. In spite of what season you go through in the year 2023, I speak an assurance that the Spirit of God is with you, that you are loved by your Father in heaven, and that he's with you in every place, and he has made provision for your every need. We commit ourselves to you, our Lord and our King. We commit this community, Mavuno Church Hillcity, to you. We wait upon you. We thank you for every plan that you have for us in 2023. We thank you because we cannot even conceive the things that you want to accomplish in our lives and through our life as a community of faith. And as we align to your will, we thank you because you will do exceedingly abundantly above everything we can think, ask, or even imagine. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people say, amen, amen. I want to give a special thank you to our online audience, but I also want you to join me in giving a special thank you to our children who have worshipped with us today. We celebrate you guys. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for being, relaxing. And our service was very long and you have been understanding. but thank you so much for worshiping with us. Next Sunday, we move back to our regular services, 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. If you're not in a discipleship group, please do not leave without putting down your details at the back so that we can plug you in. We start the Bible reading plan. It's on YouVersion. The plan is called Through the New Testament in a Year by the Bible Project. That's what we're reading together. Today is day one. God bless you and Happy New Year.